Hi, I'm Pam Heller, AccuQuilt's cutting expert.
And I'm Erica Bodker, AccuQuilt's creativity expert.
Today we couldn't be any happier as we show you how to cut and sew blocks for the Go Let's Be Friends wall hanging. This is a free pattern at AccuQuilt.com and it is a perfect weekend project. Wouldn't
it
you agree?
It really is, and it's just adorable. So let's get started by cutting out our bee and our beehive for the center block. All right, we've already cut an 8.5 by 8.5 inch square.
Yes.
Using our die. It's going to finish to 8 inches, and we've pre-fused the fabric that we're going to cut out our bee and our beehive from.
All right, so our beehive, Erica,
yes.
We have a little background, so you'll notice it's a little bit, has a little pattern on it.
Uh-huh.
And then here are the stripes for the beehive.
So clever how this is done.
Yes.
It makes it so much easier to lay it out.
And then there's a bee body.
The bee body is yellow.
Yes, and then the bee wings and another
wing.
Bee
wings.
All right, so you need a 6x12 cutting mat.
Absolutely.
Erica, I can see these shapes on tea towels and aprons and bags.
I am so excited about this
one. I'm really excited about it.
You're gonna find so many uses for this one. Okay. And bees are everywhere. Bee things are really popular right now.
All right, so Miss Erica, let's start here with our
start with our beehive.
Make sure the fat end goes down.
Okay, so I'm gonna place our hive right here.
Excellent, all right. And then do you wanna build?
Oh, let's do.
A beehive.
We're gonna start, so you're just gonna be building up from your bottom layer.
Right.
And look at this. So your top layer, and it's gonna fit just perfectly, is going to allow that little bit of the top of the background or the back of the hive fabric to shine through to give you that little top.
Yeah, and there's our little bottom piece that goes on the bottom. All right, Miss Erica, here, I'm gonna move all this.
Okay.
So now let's build our bee. So here's our bee body.
Yes.
And we cut two wings. There you go.
Don't push them down too
no,
far.
No, not two. I'll let you do a wing and
okay.
I'll do a wing. So a wing goes underneath and a wing goes on top. And I love how this quilt is finished because the designer just did raw edge quilting around it with black so you can kind of see.
And then extended it to be the little bee trail.
Yes.
Is that what you call it, a bee trail?
Yes. That's what we're calling it.
Okay, here's our other wing. There's our wing that's on top.
Perfect, and then there's our center.
There's our little, the little door to the hive.
There
right
we go.
There.
All right, I'm gonna move our pieces, Erica,
perfect.
If you wanna press that
I'm
down.
I'm gonna give that a...
And remember, quilters, we have all sorts of different fusibles on our website that you can choose
we do.
From. We also have the iron and the mat.
Oh, that is lovely. Okay.
Look at how cute
Look
that
how
is.
Look how cute that is.
All right, so Erica, for the outside of the block, you're going to need an 8-inch cube.
Okay.
And this is flying geese, so you're gonna need shapes
four
and five.
Yep.
Now, you might think these are parallelograms, but actually this is shape number five, which are just half square triangles.
Okay, and then this would be shape number eight,
yes.
Which is our rectangle.
Right, and we're gonna sew one of these sections together.
Okay.
But before we do, let's cut the pieces for our next section. So this is also shape five.
Yes.
And then this is actually the parallelogram.
Oh, it is.
Now
that's
you
right.
need a left and a right.
Oh,
so if you have
right.
patterned fabric, you'll want to make sure that you fan fold your fabric.
That's right.
Perfect.
It's like having a die race. All right, here are those parallelograms
Perfect.
For you.
Yep.
Put the fabric aside. There's our parallelograms.
Great. All righty.
So let's lay this out. That way you can get started on sewing.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll see that we're going to put those that pair together like this.
Right. And then you want to make sure when you're putting those half square triangles, we're creating an edge here.
Yes.
So you want to make sure that you're laying your half square triangles out in
Correctly.
The correct
fashion.
You know, have you not done this incorrectly before? I know I certainly
have. So many times.
This is why I keep a little design board close to me so that I can lay it out.
And you, the way you know you've done this right is if right here it lines up and then you have that little piece just peeking out.
Right, so nobody panic.
Yeah,
you know you're gonna have that little piece peeking out, but line up the bottom dog ear and then it's gonna be perfect.
And when I was sewing my pieces together, I chain stitched and did all of these sections. And then I did all the flangy sections and then all the half square triangle sections.
That way you can just chain piece. And this is such a quick, easy project, but it's just so adorable.
It really is. All right, Miss Erica, I'm gonna have you press this open.
Okay.
Because look at how perfect that came out.
I love it.
Now, while you're doing that, then I'm gonna start sewing these half square triangles together. And again, quilters, I laid out my pieces so that I sew them in the correct order.
That is a great tip.
All right, quilters. Now, we're gonna make flying geese. There's flying geese in every cube. Shape number 4 is our quarter square triangle, and shape number 5 is our small half square triangle. So I'm gonna line these pieces up, and again, they're gonna go beautifully together because we've cut off those dog ears.
All right, there you go.
Yep, and then we're gonna add shape number 8, which is our rectangle.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just gonna sew it right on top. So all of our units are gonna finish to those 4 inches. All right, Miss Erica, let's move our mat and our iron. And let's build our center block because I just think it's fabulous.
Right, so this is basically a medallion style project. It's gonna start in the center with our bee, and then we are just building out from there. So we'd go ahead and sew these rows together and then sew the 3 of those together, right?
Yes, absolutely. And look at how cute that is.
It is adorable. And how fast is that?
Now for the border, there's another block that's called the Friendship Star. And we actually used our 4-inch cube to make it.
And because of that, these are the 1-inch finished elements from that cube.
Right.
So this is actually gonna finish to 3 inches.
Right. So here are shape number 2 and 5.
Yes.
And when you sew them all together in this 9 patch, it makes the Friendship Star.
Isn't that adorable? And it's one of my favorite blocks too.
All right, quilters, since our Friendship Star finishes to 3 inches, let me give you a pro tip on the rectangle behind our little bee die. This, we used our 3.5-inch strip and then subcut it using our 2¾-inch strip right there, and then it will match perfectly for the border.
All right, so you wanna go ahead then and follow the pattern to finish that outer bee border, and then you will be so happy that you're done. You'll sandwich your batting between your quilt top and your backing, pin or baste, and quilt as desired. You wanna use your favorite binding method, and don't forget to miter those corners.
Be sure and share all your finished projects with us on all of our social media platforms. Use that hashtag AccuQuiltBuilt.
Being creative is as sweet as honey when using the Go Bee and Beehive Die, because at AccuQuilt, we'll help you cut time
so you can quilt more.